Greetings everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another interesting question. So this time we will be solving this problem using DAX in Power BI. So we have two tables called sales and products, and those two tables are joined using product ID, which we will show later in the video. So based on the product's revenue, so you have three products A, B, C and their revenue, you have to create a new column called rank based on the revenue in descending order. So that means product B is having revenue 2700, which should be 1, and next is 2000, which should be rank 2, and 1800, which is rank 3. So in this way, you need to add the rank column. So this is pretty easy to do it using SQL, but we need to see how to solve this using DAX. So these are the three tables: sales, product, and product sales. So for our purpose, we just require, for this particular example, we require only product and product sales. So for product, you have two columns, name and product ID, and product sales, you have product ID, revenue and salesperson. And you have a one to many relationship between product and product sales. And the relationship is based on the product ID column. So hope you are now good understanding the schema. So now let's go back to see how to create the ranks. So first, what I'll do, I'll create a table with name, and I'll create a new measure called total revenue. So total revenue is nothing but sum of revenue. So this is simple measure which gives the name and the total revenue. Now we want to add a new column called rank. So for that, I'll create one more measure, new measure. So rank. So now what we have to do, there is a function in DAX called rankX. And if you see the parameters, you have this table, expression, value, order and ties. So main thing are these first two parameters. First thing is the table. What table you need to give? You need to give the table for which you want to create the rank on. So here in our case, we want to rank the products. So that's why we have to give the product table, product. And expression. Expression is, you want to rank the product table based on what value. So the expression should return a particular value, and based on that value, the ranking will be done on the product table. So in our case, the total revenue, right? So, and now if you just provide these two parameters, rank will be created. And if you drag this, rank will be shown. So here if you see, all are shown as 1, because what happens, so when you create this measure, we all know measure executes on the row level. So for every row, the measure will be executed for this table. So if you see, we have used the product, and here the data is getting sliced by product. So when you slice the product, I mean, when you're checking the data for product, and here also if you are using the product, so by default for that particular row execution, only one row will be there. So that's why for every row, only rank 1 is shown. So in order to fix that, what we need to do, we have to use all. So if we write this all condition, all will make sure that whatever rank you are given, it is not based on the, it will not be sliceable. So it will not slice the product table. So that's why you have to use the all condition. So if you use the all condition, now if you see, since B is having the highest revenue, it is shown as 1. And C is having the second highest, so 2. And A is third highest, so it is 3. So in this way, we will create the rank column. So hope you all understood how to use the rankX function. If you like this video, please click on the like button, so that people who are interested to learn more on DAX and SQL, so this video will reach them. And also click on subscribe button to get more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.